Hello guys, this is Cesar Creates and welcome back to my channel. In today's episode, we are creating a gift shop for our desert adventure park. This is the continuation of our work on the entrance building, as the gift shop is basically located inside the entrance. First of all, I would like to thank you guys for clicking and watching this video. I know that the weather is amazing right now. At least at the area where I live, it is summer at its fullest. I hope you also have amazing weather outside, and I hope that you are able to enjoy it to the fullest. But thank you so much if you still have found some time to watch my video. I live in the northern part of Poland, and sunny weather and high temperatures are not too usual for us, so whenever we have a day like this, everyone is happy, everyone is talking about it. And because it is so hot, I need to have my windows open and my flat. So whenever you hear some weird noises, sorry guys, but it's so hot that I just need some fresh air. So yeah, just a little disclaimer that if you hear something unusual, please forgive me. So if you are still watching, thank you so much, and please consider subscribing to my channel, it really would mean a lot to me. As you can see, we are starting today's episode with creating the flooring for the whole building. This building is inspired, as I already told you, by the entrance to the Dubai Safari Park. So I wanted to keep this floor very similar to the original building. This floor is just tiles that create a pattern of the stripes, large stripes. The one stripe is wider and it is brighter in color, and the other stripe is narrower and it is like dark, as you can see. I got some questions before if the guests are actually able to walk on those custom floors, and the answer is yes, of course, but you still need to make sure that you put the actual path below the floor. You just need to make sure that the pieces that you create your floor with are just slightly like above the path, so the guests like don't sink their feet inside of those pieces. But yeah, if you cover those paths, the guests still will be using the paths that are underneath. They won't leave this path, they just will be, you know, walking around as usual on the paths that are, as I said, below the structural pieces. As you can see, I used also this single path piece trick to put a guard like near the entrance to our zoo. This guard is just, you know, making sure that everyone bought their tickets while they are entering the zoo. He's making sure that everything is in order, everything is safe and how it should be. If you put just one piece of path and put a staff member in there, he won't move, he won't just stay there. So if you want to make, you know, your own guard booths, your own, I don't know, checkouts or cashiers, you can just put those paths and put some of the workers on them and they will just stay there and don't move or run away anywhere. Today's speed build is a bit different from the ones that we had before. And it is because I really listen to your feedback, guys. I know that when we are building in the interiors, in the small spaces, and the speed of the video is very high, it can get a little dizzy, it can get a bit hard to watch because of, you know, fast camera movements. When I build in those small spaces, I need to rotate camera a lot. So some of you commented that those videos are a bit hard to watch. That's why today we are slowing down. This speed build will be, as I said, slower. It is still a speed build, but not in a so high tempo. That's why I decided to cut out some of the parts of this video to make it a bit shorter. I mean, I cut out the things that were just obvious to me, or the repeating of certain actions. Like, I'm sure that you'll be able to figure out how I did it when I, for example, did this flooring. I only like showed you the start of it and some, you know, starting parts of creating it, and then I skipped it. because filling this whole building with a floor was several minutes long and I didn't want to make this video longer, and I am sure that you'll be able to figure out how I did it. As you could see, I added some ivy plants to this build, and there'll be a lot of this ivy here in this video, but we need to consider it here as a fake plant. Just as it is in the real build, there are a lot of those fake vines on the ceiling and walls. It is just because it would be like very hard to grow this plant in here. It will be hard for it to look good. I am not a huge fan of fake plants, but if they do their job, which in here is to make this look like you are doing your shopping inside of a, you know, jungle, forest or something like this, then we need to go for fake ivy or fake vines, and I am totally okay with it. In a moment I will start to work on the ceiling of the gift shop. The ceiling is made out of a lot of planks and a lot of those board pieces that we used last time where we were building the capuchin monkey enclosure. When you are using a lot of planks in this game, it is very important to remember to rotate some of them so it isn't so much repetitive, because as I told you guys before, we don't have, you know, similar or the same planks when in the building materials. They're always different, so putting the identical planks next to each other is looking quite weird. So whenever I use a lot of planks, I always try to make sure that they are rotated a bit, they are moved at least a bit, so that, you know, we don't get this repetitive pattern that looks very, very weird and unnatural. So I didn't include also the entire footage of creating this ceiling because it was a lot of time. I'm sure that you will be able to figure out how I did it. The ceiling is just, you know, planks that are, you know, in different angles, and also some of those board pieces, as I told you, and they are outlined with wooden beams or however you call them. I really like this, you know, idea for a ceiling that it looks organized but also messy. It really, really like corresponds well with this entire gift shop. And this entire gift shop is also a nice contrast to the whole building, which is very, very modern. I will include the photo here on the screen so that you can see how it actually looks in the real life and what I was inspired by. So as you can see, it is like very, very African, very themed. There's a lot of wooden structures, a lot of, you know, shelves with souvenirs. There are a lot of those vines, trees that serve as pillars. So it is very, very themed. Very also cozy. I remember that there was, you know, it was very cramped, but also very nice looking. And this is something that I try to go for here to like recreate it a bit. Of course, it's still a game, so I am rather limited, but I am like very happy with the amount of detail that I was able to include in here. While building in Planet Zoo, it is really, really hard to nail the scale. You know, the scale of a building compared to the animals and compared to the guests. And this whole building, I mean, the scale of it is quite right from what I remember and from what I've seen on the pictures online. The only thing is that this gift shop is a bit too big. I don't know, maybe this whole building came out a bit like too broad, too wide or something. So this gift shop is very long. It is also long in the real building, but not so much. So I really knew that I need to cram a lot of things in there to make it cozy and not to make this like spacious, a lot of free space looking weird. My initial plan for this episode today was to finish the entire interior of this building, I mean of the entire entrance. But unfortunately, with the amount of detail that came into this gift shop, I was like unable to do it because this video will be very, very long. So yeah, today we focus on the gift shop, and in the next episode we will finish this entire building and we'll be finally able to move to the habitats. As I told you guys in my last Elm Hill City Zoo video, unfortunately, maybe not for me, but for you, I am leaving for vacations next week, so I won't be able to record any new videos. My plan is to pre-record like one or two videos so that you'll have something to watch while I am away. For sure, I will make a video in the Elm Hill City Zoo. And maybe I will also have a bit of time to make an additional video in the Desert Adventure Park where we are finishing this entrance, but I will see. So yeah, because of my vacations, I won't be able to play any of the Africa Park, the new DLC, which is very unfortunate. The timing is so not right for me this time. So don't be surprised when other content creators upload a lot of videos with animals from the new pack and I will upload something totally off topic. I hope you will still watch it, but also go and watch those videos from other content creators. They are totally awesome, so I cannot wait to see what they will create with this new building pieces, with new animals that come with an Africa pack. So yeah, I am very excited and I for sure will be watching, you know, content of other people when I am on vacation, so that I will have even more ideas for you guys here. So yeah, what I said, don't be surprised when I will upload something like not connected to the Africa Park. I wasn't given an early access or something like this by Frontier. But if this channel continues to grow in the way that it does and you guys, you know, watch my videos and subscribe, I'm sure that one day we'll be big enough so that the Frontier will actually give me the early access. I hope so, because I would love to, you know, showcase those animals and those new building pieces to you guys as soon as they are released, so you know what you can expect while buying the new pack. As you can see, I already did the flooring in our gift shop. It is a concrete floor inside of an actual building. I mean, this, you know, this concrete floor that is used for the floors, but it is in this very specific like ground color, so that, you know, you have this feeling of being in the forest while shopping, as I told you. Now we are focusing on the walls. I wanted to make them like very wooden. That's why I used those planks that we use a lot in this building. I rotated them a bit, as I told you. The planks also help with this more cozy feeling that I like try to achieve here. When I created those walls decorations from the planks, and whenever I use you know, tiles, I always try to, you know, leave this small space so that it is more realistic. I mean, when there are two planks, I always try to leave this, you know, a tiny space between them, so you have this feeling of fugue, I think that they are called, those spaces between the tiles, or dilatations. And let me just say that the game doesn't like it. Because of those tiny spaces, it starts to like flicker a bit when you move the camera. I don't know why, it looks a bit weird. It's not a texture fighting, because, you know, we are used to it when we are, you know, adding two pieces that are on the same level and they're like overlapping. There is some texture fighting, so it is easy fix. You just move one of them slightly. This is totally something different because they're not overlapping. There is just this tiny space between them, and still, it's a bit of a problem for the game, but yeah, I will leave it how it is. And I hope that you guys don't mind it when you see some weird things happening to those planks and tiles. As you could see, I added those fake trees with a lot of branches and the roots. I think that inside of those trees in an actual building there are you know, supporting pillars hidden there, so it is just a fun way of hiding them. The actual trees there have like more of the developed, I would say, branches, you know, the more dense ones, but we have only those like simple ones, so I had to use them. In the end, I still like it. Right now, maybe they look a bit weird, but just wait till the end of this video. I will add a bit of ivy, vines and so on, and they will look much, much better. I also added some, you know, circles in a different color to the ground or to the floor, so that we have a little different, you know, textures in there. It looks a bit more interesting that way. And it is also something that is used in an actual build, just to make this floor a bit more interesting and not so simple and boring. In many zoos, the gift shops are at the exit of the zoo. Because after you've seen the entire zoo, you've seen your favorite animals, you are exiting the zoo and there is a gift shop and you see a souvenir with your favorite animal, and what the zoo does is makes you spend a little more money so that it has some additional, you know, funds for the animals, for the development, for the wages. So actually buying those things is a nice way of supporting your local zoo, because I am sure that they you know, use this money well. And if you would like to see your zoo, you know, building new habitats, I think from time to time you could go and buy some little thing, some plushie, a mug or something like this, and it would be such a nice gesture. So yeah, here as well, we'll have the exit of our lovely park. Here you can see the, you know, the doors, sliding doors on the other sides of our gift shop. So it is meant to be an exit, so that after the guests have seen the entire zoo, they are leaving through this door and through this entire gift shop. They, you know, have to pass by all the shelves so they can see all the things that they potentially can buy, and maybe they will find something that they will take with them to home and pay for it. Let's hope so. But the concept of the gift shop here in the zoo is that all the, you know, visitors can go there and buy something. You can buy something right away after you just, you know, enter the zoo. It is a bit pointless, you know, to buy something at the beginning and then carry it around all the time, but hey, do whatever you want. So this like gift shop isn't like closed for all the people and is just for the people exiting. It is for everyone. But as I said, if you want to exit the park, you need to go through this gift shop. And if the Frontier gives us so much that we want in this game, and they have proven it with the recent update, there are literally so many things that we wanted and requested, and they did it, so I am very, very happy about it. So if I could request one thing right now, it would be a one-way path. This would be amazing. I mean, it would be so useful in here. Because unfortunately, I am sure that people will, you know, enter the zoo and go like inside of it through the exit, not go to the entrance that is in the different like place. So that's a pity, but we cannot do anything about it right now. But if I would be able to put like a piece of one-way path in there inside of those doors, the people won't be able to, like, you know, enter this building and go straight away through the exit, you know, to the park and watch it and start the, you know, the tour from the not right direction, from the direction that I don't want them to watch this zoo. And then I could like put the one-way path also at the entrance, and they will go right there and start the, you know, the journey in the right way. That would be amazing. And also imagine those one-way paths inside of the, for example, I don't know, big houses that you've built. You build an exit and you build an entrance, and you want the guests to like flow throughout the whole you know, building and not, you know, stop and, for example, turn around and exit it through the entrance. or enter it through the exit, you know what I mean. That would be just amazing. And if I would be able to request one thing, that will be probably the one-way path. I am so hopeful that they will be available in the future in this game. Okay, let's go back to the video. As you can see, I almost finished the work on our checkout. Or the cashier. Here the guests will like they collect their souvenir from the zoo, and then they go there, pay for it, and they can leave the zoo. So there are two employees who work there. There are two cashiers, two computers. There is also a really nice custom billboard that I added as a sign of the checkouts. As I told you guys, I create all my custom billboards with the Canva.com. It is a very, very useful site for it. I am so glad that they were added and that we are like using them from the start of the zoo, because it adds a lot to this building. I wish we had them when I started my Elm Hill City Zoo and we could like add a bit of them in the entrance part. I hope that I will have some times in the future to go back and add some of those to the Elm Hill City Zoo, but we will see. After I am done with the checkout, I will work a bit on the first set of shelves for the gift shop. As I told you guys, I wanted to keep this gift shop in this very African, ethnical style. So it has a lot of wooden shelves with this, you know, African feeling to them. The Australia planks are very useful for it, as well as the bamboo, as you can see, and some other wooden parts that I will use in a minute. I also added a little like handle to them on the lower part, so that there could be potentially a drawer or something, that, you know, there'll be some additional souvenirs stored, so that the guests buy them, you know, the shelves can always be restocked with all the souvenirs that are stored in there. I know that we've already built one gift shop here on the channel, and it was in the Elm Hill City Zoo, but I hope that you guys will see that this one is a bit different and in different style, so that, you know, you have a different source of inspiration for your gift shops to use in your zoos. Some parts are similar, of course. How can you make, you know, two totally different gift shops in this game? The one part that I really loved in our last gift shop, and that I am repeating here without any doubt, because it was one of my favorite things and it is one of my favorite blueprints ever, is the plushies. They are mind-blowing. They are something that I wouldn't be able to create, like I wouldn't have a patience to do it. So once more, I am using them here. They look so cool. They add so much to the actual gift shop, because it is so realistic to sell those, you know, in the zoo. There are always tons of those in the gift shops in zoos, so I am very, very glad that someone just went and decided to make them. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Of course, you will find the link to the Steam Workshop, to this blueprint, and to all other blueprints that I use in this build in the description to this video down. So if you want to use them themselves and download this for your parks, because I really, really recommend them. After I will be done with the plushies, I will start to work on the desk, front desk for the security guard. So that he has a computer with some, you know, screening of the cameras around this entire building, so he can be sure that everyone is safe, everything is fine, and, you know, just a really fun thing to add, really nice thing to add for our zoo. And I think it is really, really also realistic to have those guards so that the guests can feel much, much safer in our parks. After I'll be done with our guards, I will start to theme and create all the shelves for this gift shop. I will add a lot of, you know, those fabrics, African fabrics to the walls. Maybe it is a little bit over the top with all those colors, but this is something that I wanted to achieve, to be honest, because I wanted to be very cozy, very, very playful, colorful, and I think that in the end it looks very, very cool. I will also add those very large round tables that will be supported by the fake trees and some other metal, you know, supporters. They'll be a place for those bigger things that you could possibly buy in the gift shops, like, I don't know, plushies and so on. Unfortunately, in this game we don't have many props like this, so you know, everyone who is creating the gift shops is using the vases, the, you know, those Indian and African large, I don't know, pots and vases. It's not too realistic to actually go to the zoo to buy a pot or a vase, but we are using the things that we have, and yeah, they still look cool. I also put a lot of those fabric materials, a lot of carpets. If you possibly want to go to the zoo to buy a carpet, then why not? So the purpose of those large tables is to, you know, display those bigger things, bigger things that you could buy in this gift shop. After those, I'll start to focus on those smaller shelves. I discovered this really, really nice piece from the African theme that is wooden but has those zebra stripes on it, but you can recolor it, and when you change the color to the wooden color and the stripes disappear and it looks really cool. So I created like three or four sets of different types of shelves. Wooden, like African shelves that look really, really cool. So I used mainly this piece, this like square wooden tube, and also I used a lot of Australian planks, but not actual planks. We also got some, you know, signs, custom signs that you could write something on. But they are also wooden, and but you don't need to write anything on them and use them as planks, so they really, really go well in here. For other sets of shelves, I used, for example, an African post lamp, I think it is called. It also looks cool. I also used African windows, which are also really, really cool as shelves. So yeah, in case you are wondering what materials are those. I will be filling those shelves with a lot of different things, like again vases and some fabric. Also the gifts that were added with an Arctic pack. Some light switches that are turned out, they are really, really tiny, so they look like you know, tiny boxes with some things inside. I don't know, you could have boxes with some toys or something. Also those African hanging things, I like rotate them and use them as plates you could buy. I remember from my visits in zoos that there are always a lot of mugs in the gift shops with animals and zoo logo and so on, so I wanted to, I know, create a lot of mugs in here, those shelves with mugs. So I used this gutter cup, I think it is called. It's a very tiny piece. I just put them, two them of them together. I think I saw it somewhere on the, you know, on the workshop. So it's not like my thing that I created here, and it's nothing spectacular, but still it looks good as mugs. I used a lot of, you know, colorful ones. I used them a lot in here. So whenever you see those small pots or something, those are meant to be mugs. So please don't be surprised. I also didn't include all the footage of, you know, adding things to those shelves because it was so time consuming and it was a lot of work, so I didn't want to bore you guys. You will be able to see it all on the cinematic shots on the end of this video. I also created a shelf for books because I think that the books are very important to sell in the zoos as an educational source of education for the guests, so I always try to add them. There is this amazing blueprints with the books I used in the educational center in the Elm Hill City Zoo, so as well I will list it down in the description. After I will be done with all the shelves, I will focus on the left side of the gift shop. And then I will use a very, very fun blueprint of the t-shirts. T-shirts are also very typical to be, you know, sold in those gift shops. These t-shirts with animals and also again zoo logo or something like this. I saw this amazing blueprint in one of the Lay Designer videos where she showcased one of the zoos. The zoo was actually created by an incredibly talented guy who is called Natanek. He is also from Poland. He is super talented, so in case you haven't seen the Lay Designer video, definitely go and check it out. It is an Australian zoo. She makes the whole tour when she like showcases the whole zoo created by Natanek. And I remember that he had this amazing gift shop in this zoo, so this is what I wanted to use because I remember how amazed I was by those t-shirts, and I actually found this blueprint on the workshop and, you know, adjusted it a bit to fit into this part of our gift shop. And yeah, and that's how we have actual t-shirts in our gift shop. After that, I will add some other wall decorations in here and then focus a bit more on the ceiling. I will add a lot of those strings with bulbs. I know those lights that are on the strings. They give this very romantic feeling, but very industrial also feeling. I cannot believe that I just used the word romantic while talking about Planet Zoo, but yeah, I always like associate those lights, those bulbs with very like romantic restaurants and so on. So let's just leave it that way. Also, as I told you, there'll be a lot of those fake plants or ivy, fake ivy, vines and so on. I will also add a lot of those roots. Just like, you know, trees, vines, shopping inside of the jungle or something. And yeah, this is basically our gift shop. I hope that I was able to, you know, inspire you a bit. I hope that I created something similar to the actual building and to the actual gift shop. And I really hope that you enjoyed today's video despite the perfect weather that we have outside. Okay guys, this is all that I have for you today. Please enjoy the rest of this speed build. You will be able to see how we are finishing up this whole gift shop, this whole area of our entrance. As I told you, next time we will finish the building finally, so we will be able to focus on the habitats that will be outside. Please subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. You don't want to miss what's next, so definitely make sure you subscribe. So any new videos will like show up in your feed and you won't miss them. Also, like this video if you enjoyed. Click the bell if you want to be notified every time I upload a new video. Comment down below if you liked our gift shop that we created today. And if you are excited about our new Africa pack that is coming out few days from now, this is so exciting. Thank you guys for watching, have a wonderful warm day, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye guys!